immunopathological changes in the brain of immunosuppressed mice experimentally infected with Toxocara canis. Toxocariasis is a telluric zoonosis due to infection of human by larvae of Toxocara canis. Infection is acquired by ingestion of embryonated eggs of Toxocara canis, which reach the soil via the feces of infected dogs. After ingestion of eggs, the larvae penetrate the gut to migrate through the liver and the other viscera, including the central nervous system. Cases of neurological toxocariasis in human may present as meningoencephalitis with eosinophilic bleocytosis, transverse myelitis with eosinophils in the CSF, dementia, cerebral vasculitis, or seizures. Other possible neuropsychological association include social, cognitive, and behavioral abnormalities, especially in children. If detected and treated early, the prognosis of neurological toxocariasis is favorable. The number of immunosuppressed individuals worldwide continues to increase each year as the human immunodeficiency virus pandemic continues to spread unabated in many parts of the world. Moreover, the number of immunosuppressed individuals continue to increase all over the world as a result of medical interventions with aggressive immunosuppressive therapies for immune-mediated disorder and hemobiotic and solid organ transplants, with approximately 1 million transplants performed annually. The deleterious effects of immunosuppression are documented in certain helminth infections, including strongyloidiasis and experimental trichinellosis. However, few data are available regarding the influence of immunosuppression on cerebral involvement in paratenic hosts infected with Toxocara canis. This work aimed to investigate the immunological, biochemical, and pathological brain changes in normal and immunosuppressed mice experimentally infected with Toxocara canis. A total of 186 albino mice were divided into four groups, including normal, control group, immunocompetent Toxocara canis infected group, immunosuppressed group, which is control, and immunosuppressed Toxocara canis infected group. The parasite is Toxocara canis eggs obtained by flotation from stools of babies were cultured for embryonation and storage. Each mouse received 1,000 of these embryonated eggs. For induction of immune suppression, cyclophosphamide was used as a dose of 20 mg per kg body weight per day for 5 consecutive days. Toxocara infected mice were explored at 2, 5, and 12 weeks post-infection regarding the following parameter: total larval count in the brain, levels of expression of interleukin-5 transcripts in brain tissue homogenate by real-time PCR, levels of neurotransmitters, GABA, gamma-aminobutyric acid, glutamate, and dopamine in brain homogenates, histopathological examination, and intensity of gliosis. The values were statistically compared to those of non-infected control animals. As regards the larval count in the brain of infected mice at weeks post-infection, there is progressive increase in larval burden from week 2 to week 12 post-infection. There was significant increase in larval burden in the immunosuppressed infected group. As regards the interleukin-5, there is marked increase in expression of interleukin-5 in immunocompetent infected group, with significant decrease in the immunosuppressed group and the immunosuppressed infected group. When comparing interleukin-5 between immunocompetent infected and immunosuppressed infected group, there was marked difference between both groups at all time points post-infection. As regards the GABA, there is a marked decrease in the GABA in immunocompetent infected group, with a significant difference between the immunocompetent and the immunosuppressed. As regards the dopamine level, there is marked also decrease in the level of dopamine in immunocompetent infected group, which increase over time, and this increase is more significant in the immunosuppressed infected group. Glutamate also increase in the immunocompetent infected group, which also this increase is more evident over time and is more exaggerated in the immunosuppressed infected group. As regards the histopathological examination, there is section of Toxocara larvae in the brain tissue without apparent inflammation around them. And by BES staining, there is deposition of BES positive material in the wall of the blood vessel, which is supposed to be immune complexes. This is the assessment of gliosis by immunohistochemistry. At 2 weeks post-infection, there is a marked increase in gliosis in the infected group, which is more in the immunosuppressed group. At 12 weeks post-infection, there is also marked increase in gliosis, which is also more evident in the immunosuppressed group. In conclusion, experimental toxocarakinase infection induced significant immunological, biochemical, and pathological changes in the brains of infected animals. Under the influence of immunosuppression, these changes were more pronounced while the immune response was blunted, evidenced by suppressed level of interleukin-5. Also, it was found that these changes were more evident in the chronic phase of infection. Further studies are warranted as regards the course of toxocariasis in various conditions of immune suppression. Finally, more studies should be done to establish the immunopathogenetic mechanisms of neurotoxocariasis, which may open avenue for future therapeutic option. يعني الحقيقة احنا ما عملنا الدراسة دي على التوكسوكارا وجدنا ان بيحصل changes في البرين سواء بالنسبة للنيوروترانسميترز المختلفة اللي ده ممكن قوي يفسر التغيرات اللي بتحصل في البيهيفيرال changes اللي ممكن تحصل في الاطفال اللي عندهم توكسوكارا وبرضو التغيرات اللي بنلاقيها في الحيوانات المصابة بالتوكسوكارا. وجدنا برضو ان في changes في الجلايوزس يعني بالرغم ان مفيش inflammatory reaction صحيح في البرين لكن في changes في الاستروسايت بوبوليشن وده ممكن برضو بيأثر على البرين function بصورة او باخرى. كل changes دي كانت اكتر طبعا في الاميونوسابريست جروب فده يخلينا برضو نعتبر يعني او نفكر في التوكسوكارا ما يبقى عندنا immunosuppressed patient. البحث ده الحقيقة نشرناه في Korean Journal of Parasitology وكان بيشارك فيه استاذ دكتور محمد عيد استاذ دكتور سامي القراني واستاذ مساعد ايمان سعيد ودكتوره دينا الجندي. شكرا.